इवनिंग, मैं डॉक्टर योर वेबिनार कोऑर्डिनेटर एंड ऑन बिहाफ ऑफ शिवराज होम्योपैथिक मेडिकल कॉलेज आवर चेयरमैन डॉक्टर शिवराज संजय सर और एमडी डॉक्टर शिवराज कल्पना मैम एंड आवर बिलोव प्रिंसिपल प्रोफेसर डॉक्टर जी कन्नन सर ऑन बिहाफ ऑफ आवर शिवराज फैमिली वी एक्सटेंड वार्म वेलकम टू ऑल द फैकल्टी मेंबर्स प्रैक्टिशनर्स एंड डियर स्टूडेंट्स पार्टिसिपेंट्स प्लीज टर्न ऑफ योर माइक. So as a part of Swara seminar, today we have seventh session and the topic of session is magnesium group and its salts. We have an excellent speaker today, Dr. Maheshwari Madam. Welcome, ma'am. So a few words about the speaker. Dr. Maheshwari Ma'am has graduated from Dr. Allu Ramlingayya Government Homeo Medical College and Madam has 12 plus years of you know, practical experience at Sri Krishna Ishwari Homeo Clinic, Hyderabad. Madam is associated with Swara Homeo Gurukul for the past 3 years and she is well known for her simplicity, humbleness and the care she extends towards her patients, whomsoever reaches her doorsteps. And she is disciple of Dr. E. Krishnamacharya, who served the poor and suffering humanity of every remote places of both Telugu state with classical homeopathy in 1960s. Madam is disciple of Dr. Krishnamacharya. So we are excited to learn so many things from you, ma'am. A warm welcome. Please, ma'am, stage is yours.
Hello. Hello.
Am yes, ma'am.
Good evening, ma'am. Thank you for your warm welcome. Good evening, all. Good evening, my dear friends, students, colleagues, and practitioners. Hello, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am. You're audible and visible also. Yes.
I started screen sharing, ma'am. Is it visible?
Not yet, ma'am. Your screen is visible, but slides are not visible yet. Please click the green button share and then choose the file.
Share screen.
Yeah, screen is visible, ma'am.
Okay.
Please make it slideshow.
Yes, ma'am.
Full screen.
Yeah. Good evening, everyone. As ma'am told, thank you for your warm welcome, Dr. Kirtika, ma'am. As ma'am told, he is my guru, Dr. E. Krishnamacharya, Master E.K., well known as Master E.K. And on this auspicious evening, I am starting the session with humble pranams to my guru. Yes, and this is a wonderful session from Shivaraj Homeopathic Medical College and Research Institute, Salem. Sir, the chairman, sir, Shivaraj, Sanjay, and Dr. Kannan, sir, and Kalpana, ma'am, it's very, very wonderful session. In this pandemic, reaching the homeopathic lectures to each and every part of our country, it's a very good session, sir. Thank you, sir. Thank you for arranging and having this session. Today's my topic is understanding of magnesium and its salts. So, it's not just It's not just knowing and memorizing the signs and symptoms from the Mater Medica. So it's understanding of magnesium and its salts. So any idea what's the difference in simply reading the Mater Medica and understanding certain medicinal remedies? Any idea? Students, please make it in chat box. So, understanding, the dictionary meaning of understanding is getting knowledge, having complete insights, having comprehension. So, this is not just a superficial reading and memorizing or recollecting while treating the patients. This is not the simple thing. This is having the complete comprehension and having the insights of a certain medicinal substances. As our master Dr. Hahnemann told in the Organon of Medicine, the third aphorism, the physician must and should have the complete knowledge of the person in front of us, that is the patient, and also we should have the knowledge of the medicinal substances. So the word the master used is the knowledge. So previously I too used to just to mug up some matter from the Materia Medica of different authors, and I used to while treating the patients, and I used to just recollect, and is this symptom is fitting to this person or not, in that way I used to prescribe. But after going to Swara, what I learned is this is not just this mugging up is not enough for having the 100% results of our great system of homeopathy. So this is for a physician who wants to practice the correct homeopathy way of method, he must be got familiarized with the complete understanding of these medicinal properties. So I put the title, this is understanding of magnesium and its salts. Okay. So for having the complete knowledge of any medicinal property, we should have to understand from its source where this medicinal substance it comes from and its toxicological effects and its chemical properties. And after having the provings from the Mater Medica, the symptoms which got repertorized, so the knowledge of repertory and as well as the symptoms or the properties which were cured, that is clinically verification. After clinical verification, that symptom, that property is significant to that medicinal substance. So for to get complete understanding of any substance, it is required to know where from the substance comes from and its toxicological properties, what are the chemical properties. If it is a mineral, where, in which place this substance is located in the periodic table, the repertorial understanding, and as well as confirmation from the clinical cases. So in this journey, let's we begin to understand these magnesium salts in this way. So many of us might have very well knowledge from Mater Medica, but look here, these are the two rubrics that meant me to understand the deeper study of magnesium group of elements, that is dreams of fire, burning brightly, shrieking out for fire. This is the single remedy rubric of magnesium carb. Have you ever seen this rubric? See how this rubric came from. And one more rubric is food desires, vegetables, fruits, salads, and as well as desires and as well as the aversion to vegetables. Again here, magnesium carb, magnesium ure, and magnesium sulf. Why this is a mineral, where from this desire for fruits, vegetables, salads, as well as the aversion towards these came. This is something interesting, right? So, as all of us know, the single remedy rubrics are very, very important for us. So, in knowing how these rubrics came, what's the reason to the as this medicinal substance has these property, where from these property came from, in that part of journey we will move ahead. So coming to the source understanding, so magnesium is the ninth most abundant element in the universe. It is amorphous silvery white alkali metal, and it is the most 11th abundant element by mass in the human body. So this is the alkali metal. See, this is the 11th abundant element in the human bodies. Just know how significant this element is for us. So this much important is the magnesium have its role. Let's see the biological role of magnesium. It is essential for both plants and as well as for animals. Chlorophyll is a magnesium-centered porphyrin complex. See how this is related to the rubric, vegetables. See, chlorophyll, that is the magnesium-centered porphyrin complex, which is essential for green leafy vegetables for the photosynthesis, right? So in humans, it is essential for working of hundreds of enzymes, and it is mainly stored in the bones. This much significance this magnesium salt has in our body. So what is the daily requirement? The daily requirement of magnesium is 300 to 400 milligrams per day. So what are the rich food substances so that we can get that much to fulfill that requirement? The fruits, green leafy vegetables, seeds, beans, dry nuts, curd. So these are the wheat germs. These are the rich sources of magnesium. See how the rubric desire and aversion to fruits, salads, vegetables, where from this came? So this is the reason the magnesium is present. This is abundantly present in these vegetables. So the magnesium patients, they have the dream, the desire, as well as the aversion towards these type of food substances. This is something interesting, right? So let's try to understand the magnesium through the periodic table. In periodic table, the magnesium, it is placed in row 3 and column 2. So I think all are got familiarized with the issues of periodic table, and also the row 3 and column 1, that is natrum. Our previous speaker, Dr. Gautam, has excellently told about all these things. So this magnesium, this is situated in row 3 and column 2. So these row 3, this denotes 3 to 6 years of human development. And this is the stage of development after getting separated from the mother. So after taking the birth, the issues that follow, they comes under row 3. So not just from books, just in a general manner, we try to understand what could be the issues of row 3. So after taking birth, what will happen? We give nourishment, right? Food and nourishment to the child. Later, we give him some name. Giving name is nothing but giving him the identity. So from today onwards, you will be called with so and so name. Name is nothing but the identity to that particular individual. So the row 3 issues, they start from I am separate, I have some identity, and I want some nourishment, some food. So I am having this physical existence. So the main issues of row 3 are identity, image, choice, and ego. So after having this identity, what the child used to do. It just cries for food, nourishment, care, and warmth from the mother. Later, it slowly starts smiling on seeing the face of the mother. This is nothing but recognizing. It slowly starts recognizing the mother. Later, the other family members. Slowly, as the development progresses, it starts recognizing the outer things like the neighbors, what is going on, right? And slowly, gradually, it also starts making choices. It wants to grab the toys or it wants to play with some persons, right? Okay. Then it slowly starts expressing itself. I want this, I want that. So the ability to express also starts. Later, while judging the things, it starts, this is right, this is wrong. I want to be with my parents, this is right. And if I go somewhere, that is not good for me. So this type of discrimination, the child slowly develops. Later, it becomes self-conscious. So as a part of becoming self-conscious, the issues of appearance start. So if I go outside, which type of dress I should wear? Which color is suitable for me? In how I have to go? How I have to dress up? So what the other people will think of me if I go like this? So slowly the child starts knowing, that is getting aware of the impressions of others. Later, as to be identified in the society, it starts wanting to be different. If I am like this, then can I blend with these people? Or to get to be identified, I may have to be different. So this type of thinking starts. So these are all to get to be identified, to have some image in the society. So as a part of identification, the child starts all these, it learns all these things. So whenever some person, they are not appropriately, reciprocally responding to this person, they start embarrassed, they feel embarrassed. For a second, no one is there for me. No one is looking at me. Am I alone? Slowly it starts the fears. Fear of going to some places. Fear of darkness. So these kind of things the child slowly develops. Later on, if it continues for longer time, I am lost. So there is total disappointment also begins. Lost and direction. So there will be the homesickness. Sometimes the people may get attached to some specific things. This is how the issues of row 3 slowly develops from one column to another column in row 3. So as part of column 2, just we will have a small differentiation between column 1 and column 2. So in column 1, the physical existence is there, but the child is having some little hesitation that am I separate or not? Because since 9 months, it is in mother's womb. Just now it took birth. So am I separate or still I am in mother's womb? This is the thing. Just within few days, it realizes that yes, I have my own physical existence. But what the thing is, I don't know what I want. So for these things, I have to depend. I don't know what I want, what food I need, what kind of care, what kind of nourishment I need. So the child is completely unaware of these things. So it totally depends upon the mother. So what it says, you have to take care of me. You have to feed me. You have to make me to laugh. You have to play with me. I don't know. I'm very clingy. I'm completely dependent on you. So This is not in terms to the child or the small kid. This may happen in any part of our life. This is the developmental issue. That is in psychological way. This is not the physical thing of the small kid. So though the adults ones, though they are adolescent, suppose if they are in 20s, in 30s, it may happen even in 40 years of age also. Though they are developed physically, their way of thinking is like that. Give me the dress, I have to go to party, because I can't judge which kind of dress is suitable for me. So this type of complete dependency we can see in column one. So this is one-to-one relationship. Okay, this is the thing of natrum. Next, coming to column two. Now the child realizes that yes, my existence is there. I'm separate, but who am I? Where is my identity? How can I get the identity? For that, I have the identity because of my parents. This is not identity because of me, because I am too small. For this identity, I have to depend on my parents. The child or the person who belongs to column two, they start just making the choices. They start to do things on their own. It just starts to express what they want. Just it's the beginning of expression. Just the making of choices. So as a part of this, what it thinks is, if I start to do all these choices, if I make the choices on my own, the person on whom I am dependent, from whom I am seeking this emotional support, whether they love me or leave me. So this kind of thinking we can see the persons belonging to column two. So in this picture, we can see the child, he is crying. Just he cries for what he doesn't know. He just cries. This is the mother's duty to see what food is. It needs the food, or it needs the cloth, or it needs the warmth and care, whatever it may be. So it's the duty of the motherly figure. So I'm very much clingy. I'm totally dependent on you. You have to look after me. You have to take care of me. This is the main essence of row three and column one, people's situation. Okay, let's move further. So in column two, row three and column two people, how will be their expressions? Let's see. I have some specific name. That is, the identity just has begun. Call with my name. I started choosing. I can choose which is good, which is bad. I can recognize the surroundings. This is daytime. This is nighttime. Okay. This is right. This is wrong. And I can express myself. But it's just the beginning of the expression. So how the survival mechanism will be in column two people? They seek for relationships. They seek for the relationship. That relation should understand them. With that relationship, they have to be familiar. That should be a comfort zone. The relationship in terms of communication. That relationship gives them the confidence. On that relationship, they can trust. So this kind of attachment, they start. So let's have the complete understanding of magnesium. So I'm separate. I have identity. That is from my parents. I can choose, make decisions, can express myself, but I need some emotional support. This is in Dr. Rajan Shankaran described that it is a provisional tent, this situation, this column two people are. What is the provisional tent? It is just as far as the surroundings are favorable, then they can carry on. But whenever there is a small disturbance, they will go back to the original home. So this is exemplified for our understanding purpose. So you are everything to me. They need some motherly figure. So they are everything for me. I am incapable. Without you, I have no identity at all. For your love, care, and for everything, I will sacrifice even my choices. So at any threat to this support, there will be a total breakdown in these kind of people. So if at all it happens, they feel that I am orphan. No one is there to identify me, to feed me, to look after me. They feel abandoned, lost in direction. So they develop homesickness. Later on, if these situations prolong further, they may develop into nutritional and developmental issues. So here is a small video. Let's see how the child.
Hi, I'm Casey.
And I'm Reese.
We're here to talk to you about decisions.
But what is a decision?
A decision means choosing what you want to do. It's called making your mind up.
Decisions can be small or they can be big.
Sometimes decisions can be so big they need more than one person to help make them.
Let's go to the moon!
Yeah, let's go to the moon!
We're going to the moon!
There are heaps of examples of people making decisions.
We'll go east. We'll go west. We'll go east. No, we'll go south.
He kept changing his mind. But that's okay.
We can all make a decision and change our mind later if we want to.
These decisions are big decisions, but we all make small decisions every day.
I'll wear the blue one.
See, that was easy.
Let's look at some other day-to-day decisions.
Like, what will I have for breakfast?
Decision, I choose toast.
Decision, I choose cereal.
See? People can make different decisions.
I've decided to go to the park, but how will I get there?
Decision, I'll ride my skateboard.
Decision, I'm going to catch the bus.
See, they are day-to-day decisions.
What to wear, what to eat, where to go, how to get there.
But remember, we don't have to make decisions about everything at once.
And we don't have to make decisions on our own.
You can talk to other people because some decisions need thinking and talking about.
That's right. They're what I call big decisions.
Staying at school, is that a big decision?
It sure is. Deciding to stay at school or go to TAFE or somewhere else is a big decision.
What about looking for a job? Is that a big decision?
Yep, looking for a job and going to work. They're big decisions too.
So those decisions need lots of thinking about.
That's right, but we're not deciding anything right now. We're just looking at the choices.
We can think about them and we can talk about them with other people.
Now this is the important bit. Here's what we need to remember about making decisions.
Cool.
I'll say them and together we can repeat them. I have the right to make decisions.
I have the right to make decisions.
I can make decisions.
I can make decisions.
I can learn from trying things out.
I can learn from trying things out.
I can talk to other people.
I can talk to other people.
I can change my mind if I want to.
I can change my mind if I want to.
I can make decisions other people don't like.
I can make decisions other people don't like.
I can make decisions that are different to other people's decisions.
I can make decisions that are different to other people's decisions.
Well done.
It's a lot to remember.
Yes, but you can watch this again or ask someone about it any.
So. This is how the child starts making the decisions. So understanding of magnesium further, there will be lot of fears, the fear of dark room, the fear of known, unknown, familiar and unfamiliar, abandoned, forsaken feeling. So all these things the child slowly starts noticing. The fear of ghosts, the fear of darkness, twilight. So what is the essence of magnesium is, they have the symbolic dreams. The dreams of magnesium are very symbolic. Dreams of houses, weddings, water, as if he is drowning in the water. The floods are coming, overflowing of water, death of relatives. So the peculiar thing in magnesium is, in dangerous situations, the person, he might be completely fearless. So one side there is fear and the other side there is complete fearlessness. This is the polarity we can see. So the person may get flood, the dreams of water. He just stand beside the sea water, the flood is coming, but he is completely fearless. In one of my patients, what I saw is the person described that the dream as if he stand in the midst of so many snakes, different snakes. They are coming towards him. They are coming, they are crawling over him. So I asked, what's the experience in the dream? No, ma'am, there is no nothing. I am completely fearless. Yeah, is it right? I asked again for confirmation. Yes, I am normal. How am I now? Same. That is the issue. That is the same experience in my dream. So the issue of fear, it has both the polarities. One side there is fear for very, very small things, and the other side in even dangerous situations also is completely fearless. So later on, the person develops, no one is there, no one to take care of me. I'm just like an orphan without any identification and all. What are the exciting factors for these magnesium patients? Any quarrels, disputes, or any divorce in the parents, in the childhood, they will lead to major pathological changes in the next coming years. Any threat to motherly figure, it may not be the mother, it may be the spouse or any friend. So any disputes between the friends also, they will lead to some issues in further development. So the child feels forsaken, abandoned, lost direction, homesickness. All these will lead to the growth and developmental issues. So this is one more video. As the session is going to end, just I will play this. What will be the impact of these parental?
Ayaka shoulders her family's duty to cherish the aspirations of ordinary people. But she also has dreams of her own.
The parental conflict, how they will impact the child. And their children do better.
But we know it can be hard for couples to keep their relationships happy and healthy. Around 1 in 5 married or cohabiting couples are in relationships classified as distressed. That means they argue a lot, regularly consider separating, or regret being in their relationship. Conflict between parents can be easily triggered, often by common things that upset normal daily life. This could be problems with money, or at work, or because of ill health. And around half of all couples say their relationships become strained after the arrival of a new baby. But it can be easy to forget that when relationships are strained, it is children who suffer the most. Children exposed to frequent conflict are at greater risk of depression and anxiety, and are more prone to problems with their physical health. They're also more likely to develop behaviour problems and to do worse at school. And this can have a knock-on effect later in life on an adult's relationships, employment, and their psychological well-being. And that's quite apart from the cost to society. Family breakdown has been estimated to account for £47 billion worth of public spending every year. But this is a problem we have the means to address.
Into this magnesium group remedies, they're undemanding, reserved, they're quite passive. They don't ask so many questions. There will be inability to express their choices. If we ask which food you want, if you take him to the restaurant, if we ask which food you want, whatever you can, that will be okay with me. So they have difficulty in expressing. They have the thing to make the choice, but they have difficulty in expressing it. So it is very difficult to elicit the cravings and aversions for food. They are not able to express even their feelings also. They may feel sad, they may feel bad, but don't know why you are so like that. They didn't tell. So these things we can see in magnesium.
Excuse me, ma'am. Dr. Ram Mohan, please mute yourself. Yes, ma'am. Please continue.
So, these are like news readers. How the news reader will be? How he will be? If they tell the news of any bomb blasting, they are just very plain, calm. They will say in a very low voice. Those expressions, those feelings are not, we can't hear in news reader. So that kind of placid speech will be there. Their emotions are not at all expressed. Very, very superficial, though they might have so many number of friends, the relations are very superficial. And it is very difficult for us to take the magnesium people also. So, I think I conveyed the idea of magnesium. Let's move on to the salts of magnesium. Let's see the answer for the first rubric. Why the dreams of fire, the dreams of waking light? Let's see that answer. Maybe we can get the answer from this further coming session. So magnesium, it has only 2 electrons in the outer orbit. So it is readily gives up these 2 electrons and tries to make a stable component. Let's see the understanding of magnesium from its toxicology. When any person got exposed, overexposed to magnesium, or if they consume over amount of magnesium, the symptoms what they developed, they are not that much carcinogenic. They are light, like mild toxicity. They are non-carcinogenic. The symptoms developed are lethargy, diarrhea, nausea, vomiting. There will be muscle weakness, urine retention, and maybe breathing difficulties. So,
Screen is not visible.
Now, is it okay, ma'am?
Actually, the slide share is not visible, ma'am. Your image is visible, but slide share is not visible. Maybe we have to share once again. Yes.
Now is it okay, ma'am?
Yes, ma'am, it's visible.
Sorry.
No, it's fine.
So, as per the toxicology, what are the sphere of action of magnesium? Yeah, it has the magnesium acts mainly on neuromuscular junctions, the nerves, liver, mucous membranes, the growth glands, that is thyroid gland, prostate gland. There will be the issues of growth and nourishment. Many, many GIT disorders comes under these magnesium salts. So let's have a look on the affinities of magnesium salts. The magnesium carb, it is well known for the gastrointestinal disorders. Magnesium carb, it is well known remedy for constipation, ailments after sea bathing, and many, many chronic liver disorders. Magnesium fast, as we all know, very good remedy for these neuralgias, membranous dysmenorrhea, angina pectoris, very, very colic. It is a specific remedy for colics. Magnesium sulf, and it has the affinity over skin and urinary problems. Next, coming to the chemical properties. What are the chemical properties? Let's see. As we already told, the outer two electrons, they will easily shared by this element, and they ignites easily and burns with on exposure to oxygen, the magnesium, it ignites easily and burns with bright light. Chemically, this substance is very active. It joins with most of the metals and with almost every acid. So after joining with the acids, after having the chemical reaction, the acids, that is magnesium-ur with hydrochloric acid, magnesium-ur is the final component. Same manner, magnesium nitrate. So after getting reaction with the acids, these stable components will later, what are the applications of the magnesium? Let's see. As we already told, this is a very lightweight material. So it has very low density. Its property of high strength to weight ratio. The weight is minimal, but its strength is very, very high. Its high stiffness to weight ratio. There is strength as well as the stiffness. The ratio between the stiffness and weight, it has countless applications in aerospace, automotive, and industrial fields. So it has biocompatible, bioabsorbability. With these things, it has a great role in medical field also. The stents, they are made up of magnesium only. The pacemakers, they are also made of magnesium. So with these properties, magnesium has that much role in medical as well as in electronic fields. With its high resistance to heat, it is used as a refractory material in furnace linings for producing metals. Did you got the point? In refractory furnaces, this magnesium is used for the lining substances. So this is how the dream of the fights is connected to the chemical properties of magnesium. Let's try to understand the magnesium car. It is a, in crude form, it is used as an antacid. Toxicologically, it impairs the neuromuscular transmission and results in weakness and hypoflexia. It is used in manufacturing units with high external temperature, widely used in the furnaces, and it is used as a fire extinguisher. It is a psychotic remedy. Magnesium is the essence of a group of remedies. The theme of magnesium is, that is forsaken feeling. I am alone. I am abandoned. No one is there to take care of me. This is what we understood in the previous session. So coming to the understanding of carbon. Carbon, it is placed in the column 14, where this is the issue of the in birth canal, the head completely engaged, fixation is done, and it's the stage where the birth takes place. Further, the birth takes place. So this is the first sign of I. There is nothing of going back. The child has to come out with its force, with its reaction. It has to come out of the birth canal. So the central theme of carbon is vital reaction. I have to take control. This is the time I have to take the control. This is the issue of carbon. So the main feeling of magnesium carb is the care, the protection, the nourishment. When they lack in these issues, there will be tremendous vital anxiety. So in adults, this anxiety, the feeling of an orphan is not at all expressed. Being a child, the feeling will be there that I am alone, no one is taking care of me. But as the child develops into an adult, the feeling of orphan is completely lost. This is what is called a repression. So the patient is even unaware of what he feels actually. There will be complete repression of emotions that will result into tremendous causeless anxiety, and there will be the fear of something will happen to the loved ones. This causeless anxiety is expressed as the tremendous fear that something may happen to the closer ones, that will result in the sleeplessness. So let's see what's the difference between suppression and repression. Suppression is pushing down what comes up. So they feel the emotions, but they won't allow them. They wantedly keep them inside. That is pushing inside. That is suppression. That what we see in NATRA. Then what is this repression? Repression is not allowing the feelings to come up at all. So there is no voluntary doing. That will happen on their own. So this is called repression. This we can see in magnesium group of elements, especially in magnesium carb. Let's move further. Let's try to understand this magnesium carb from its rubrics, that is repertorial understanding. There will be fear that something may happen to the closed ones. Besides oneself being anxiety from, there will be causeless sleeplessness. There will be no reason. There will be no stress, nothing. But they are sleepless. And the forsaken from the beloved, his parents, wife, friends, the dreams of lost at home. This is something interesting, right? He is in home, but he feels that I am lost. There will be, the sleep will be unrefreshing. After awakening, there will be tired feeling. Dreams of bathing in boiling water. Again, this dream, what we spoke earlier. So, As this metal is used in the furnaces, this dream of bathing in boiling water, this we can see in magnesium. Besides oneself being anxiety prone, so just I will share a case. It is an acute case, but he repeatedly complains of dyspepsia, acidity. There will be, he will suffer with belchings, sour belchings, heaviness, burning, so loss of appetite. All these, this totality used to suffer. So I used to give him Carbovege, Lycopodium, all these remedies. So one time he again complained of dyspepsia, but on asking, on inquiring, there is no exciting factor. What's the reason you are suffering this time? No, there is nothing. Then I asked him, are there any changes in your daily routine in past 2 or 3 days? What he told, I saw a movie, that is some adventurous movie. The series of movies he saw since those 2-3 days. So series of movies, this is something interesting, right? What made you to see that series within 2-3 days? That is, they are very much interesting. There is very adventurous movie. It is like, what attracted you very much in that? I asked further. So what he told, there will be group of people who are chasing him. So the villain, the hero is running away, and these group of people, they are chasing him. And what the hero used to do is, he used to find, he's going to treasure, going to find the treasure. So in this is very interesting. He, in the hero, he moves from hills, on the road, in the forest. So he, this is the only the thing. Only the thing is chasing, but it will be in interesting way. So what's the experience while watching that moment? I asked. What he told is, as if I am there and I am running, those people are coming and chasing me. This is the experience what I got, that person told. So this is besides oneself being anxiety from. I recollected this rubric and I gave him magnesium carb 200. For my surprise, he used to suffer 3 to 4 times in a month with this dyspepsia. So it's almost 3 to 4 months. No, that those spells, they are completely gone. So this is one of my experience. So I'm going to share a chronic case now. This is from my senior, Dr. Srikant sir, the previous speaker. What I thought is, this will be worth sharing so that we can have more understanding of magnesium. So this is a case of depression. A female of 28 years married, but she married a man from another religion. So mother-in-law is a little reluctant towards this girl. She used to force her convert into my religion, like that. There will be some issues, but she is reluctant. So after having a journey, she conceived, but it was aborted. So one of the homeopaths, later on, the depression and everything got started. So basing on this history, the other homeopath gave Ignatia 1 m, 10 m, Strapsegria 1 m, Pulsatilla 1 m, 10 m, but there is no result at all. So after taking the case, in our way of case taking, in sensation method, what she narrated is, life is like always. Life is always like this. There is no growth. Nobody loves me. No one cares me. Since my childhood, it used to happen. In my childhood, there will be the quarrels between my parents. They are busy in quarreling only. They didn't spare time for taking care of myself. So I developed fear of losing. What's the experience in that moment, sir asked. I am alone, deserted, like an orphan. there is no reciprocation of love. So further probing into the dreams of her own death, she used to get these kind of dreams. One more peculiar dream is, in the dream, she used to climb the staircase. So she reaches the terrace. After reaching the terrace, if she wants to come back, she can't see the staircase. There will be no steps. This is peculiar dream, right? So this is what will be the experience here? This is lost, no direction. This is what we already discussed. So in magnesium people, there will be the thing, the symptom of lost. There is no direction. How beautifully expressed in this dream, right? So I'm further asking, what's the experience in that particular moment of being lost? That is suffocation, breathlessness, sweating of whole body. So basing on these things, these signs and symptoms are prescribed magnesium carbonate. So after a few months, she came with happiness. There is overall development as well as there is change in her dreams also. Now she is able to see the steps. She can come back from the terrace, right? So this is the amazing homeopathy. With homeopathy, the wonders will happen. See how happy that person will be. Yes, let's going back to another case. This is my case. The case of hypothyroidism. 24 years girl, she is an engineering student suffering with hypothyroidism, obesity, menorrhagia, as well as irregularity of menses. She also complained of restlessness in sleep, lot of nightmares. She used to shout, scream in the sleep. Her sister told that no one dares to sleep beside my sister. That much screaming will be there. Okay. So there is profuse sweating of palms and soles. This is so much profuse. If she comes into my clinic, I used to tell her, please have the doormat below your feet. Otherwise, I have to mop after she going out of my clinic. That much heavy, profuse sweating. And for the palms also, while during the examination, she used to keep the hand towel so that the paper won't be torn out. So that much heavy sweating is there. She is a very studious student. Excellent profile. She has very excellent profile. She conducts seminars. She is a good speaker. And she runs some journals. She has extracurricular activities with outstanding performance. She is very, very outstanding person. She sings, she dances, and she gives stage performances also. So basing on this symptomatology, I prescribed her platina, silicea, phosphorus, ferramet. Almost for one and a half hour, I treated her with these kind of remedies. But the result is very minimal, almost nothing to say frankly. So after coming from the first workshop in Swara, I again take the case again. So this time she was very sad. Otherwise she is a very lively person. This time she came with sad mood. What happened? Why are you looking so dull? I asked her. She told that there is an issue with mom. What's the issue? What's the experience? I asked. My mother told me to have this nose pin as I grown up, but I don't want this. I'm not interested in having that nose pin. So this is a small thing. Now, what's the worry? I asked further. Yes, it's a small thing, but every time she forces me and I have to follow her orders. So what's the issue? Why can't you tell her? You can tell, I don't want to know. I don't need this. You can tell, Yes, but I can't tell to her. This is what I told. So, and for what's the experience in that moment when she forces her and asks her further? Suddenly, her mood changed. She said, "Oh my God." And she just wept like anything for about 10 to 15 minutes. She continuously wept, wept, wept. Why? What happened? I can't understand. She told that, yes, now I can remember the things since my childhood. Just now I have that spark. Previously, I'm not aware of these things will happen, but just now I'm getting recollecting the issues in my childhood. These issues are common to me, from wearing the frocks, for purchasing the color of the dresses, purchasing any toys for me. Since my childhood, I always compromised with my choices. Every time I used to take the thing what is given by my mother. So suddenly she went back to her past events. Then in that narration, she continued that, so why can't you tell? You can tell na. That's I asked again. Yes, my mother used to tell that my sister is very stubborn. My mother used to scold me always that she is very stubborn girl. So what I thought is, if I also make my own choices, I may be in my mother's situation, I will be the stubborn child. So I won't start to express my choices. So this is how the child forgot all these issues. This is nothing but the repression of magnesium carb. So though they are very long and deep impact, they just forget about all these things as they grown up as the adult. So this is the thing to understand, repression of magnesium. So I asked in second area, I inquired in second area, why you are doing so many things, that kind of making journals, dancing, singing, so many extracurricular activities, what made you to do all these things? She replied, just I'm surprised. It is all to be a good child in my mother's view. So that's very funny. I just remember those moments. I'm very surprised. She's an extraordinary performer. Why she is making all these things just to be a good child in the mother view? So coming to the case, sleep, the dreams of ghosts, nightmares, the sleep, the very restless sleep. She used to kick the other persons. So very unrefreshing. She used to get headache after waking up. So in the dreams, she also told as if the ghost is coming and about to kill her. Then I asked, what's the experience? It's like a breathless. I have to fight. I have to struggle. I have to come out of the hands of the ghost. So in this fight, there will be profuse cold and clammy sweats that she used to drench with the sweating. So basing on this totality, I prescribed her magnesium carb 202 doses, repeated once in a month for 3 months. After 3 months, to my surprise, there is no sweating at all. Even during her examination also, there is no sweats at all. There is some little menstrual irregularities there, just 40 days, once in a 40 days it is coming, but it's controllable. Within 5 days, the bleeding will stop. So this is the thing. Next, coming to magnesium muir. So this is the salt of magnesium and chloride. What is the theme of chlorine? There is the feel of betrayed, hurt, let down by the identity. So the They need some identity, but what's the relation with these identities? This identity, they may let down, they may betray them. So with this kind of understanding, they start for the supporting figure outside the home. The main theme of Myriaticum is betrayal of trust. So there will be the repulsion. I don't want you because you may betray me at any moment. So pushing away, rejecting you. His trust and faith on the people on whom he depends so much for emotional support and identity will be betrayed. This is the theme of Magnesium Mirror. So they start depending on the friends. So as they start developing on friends, there will be the fear of they may lose the friends. That is developed as a delusion of being friendless. Dream of lost in forest. This is also as if outside they are missing. In Magnesium car, it is inside the house, inside their home, they are not getting the love and care. So the rubric of being lost in his own house, that is the rubric of Magnesium car. And for Magnesium Mirror, it is being lost in a forest, that is outside the house. So these Magnesium Mirror people are, they are capable of making friends outside if they make the efforts. What's the difference between Magnesium Mirror and Natrum Mirror? Magnesium Mirror people, they start depending or making friend company of small children, and they also have make the company of animals. So with this betrayal theme, they start depending on small children and animals. Whereas the Natrum Mirror patients, they cherish the music, that is non-human relationships. They seek for non-human relationships, the Natrum Mirror people. There will be also fear of betrayal, but it is complete betrayal on humanly relationships for the Natrum Mirror. But coming to Magnesium, the relationship on whom they depend, the betrayal thing will be with, that is restricted to only that figure. So there will be repulsion from that figure, and they start making from friends outside. They depend on friends. What are the dreams of Magnesium Mirror? These are the dreams of falling into water, lost in a forest. See, falling into water, where this dream came. This is the source dream of Magnesium, the seawater. Okay, lost in a forest, that is outside the home. They venture on outside, but they lost. The fear of losing the friend, that is expressed as lost in forest. There is rescuing his family from danger. Friends and relatives, they may go away on a train, leaving him behind. This is also the dream of Magnesium Mirror. There will be the dreams of fire. See how these dreams are related to their chemical properties. So, delusion of being friendless, forsaken feeling, talk indisposed to, desire to be silent, taciturn. There is also conversation aggravation. Delusion of visions of fire. There is the desire for vegetables, especially cauliflower and broccoli. This is also the source dream of Magnesium Mirror. So let's go further. Let's have a small recap of these row three elements to move forward for the Magnesium, other source of Magnesium. So in sodium, how the identity issue moves on in the row three, just let's have a glance. There is no separate identity for this Natrum people. Magnesium people, parents are their identity. So in alumina, there is the confusion of identity. In phosphorus, they start finding the identity outside the home. So they depend on friends. In silicia, there is some definite image. They want to have the identity in a specific manner. in specific work, in specific deed, they want to get that identity. So as it progresses in sulfur, there is complete development of identity. So they are proud of being having that identity. So they develop the thing that I know better than you. So no need of depending on anyone. So this is how the identity issue progresses in road three elements. Next, there is the salt of magnesium sulfuricum. This is known as the Epsom salt. It is used as an healing agent and pain reliever. Magnesium has the feeling of infantile dependence, and it is attached with the sulfur. So the theme of effort, sulfur theme is effort, appearance and ego. The row three is appearance. As we all know, sulfur, the issues of appearance, the show off is more in sulfur, right? So the theme is the person, in order to get the support from that person, I have to make big effort to do many things to appear proper. So they start making unsuccessful efforts to dress up for a party. So the dependence in magnesium sulf is I have to make lot of effort to get the support of that person. So they make lot of effort to appear in the public in a very good manner. What are the rubrics of magnesium sulf? Dreams of unsuccessful efforts to go to theater, dreams of drowning, dreams of fire, falling into water, dreams of dead relatives. There will be the desire for salads. There, as in sulfur, as we all know, self-content, content with himself. I am grown up, I am matured. There is no need for dependency of sulfur is expressed as content with himself. So there is also desire for salads. See how the source thing is coming on and on. They make lot of efforts to go to theater. These are also the dreams of magnesium sulf. The drowning, dreams of fire, dreams of falling into water. So let's move to magnesium silicate. It's only 1 minute. Let's take a break and we'll rejoin. Okay. It's less than 1 minute now. So this is how to understand the magnesium salts. Why this rubric came? So just mugging up the Metro Medica, that is not good for us. That won't help us in our practice. Why this rubric came? Why this symptom we can see in the patients? In that manner, we have to understand where from this symptom came from where. Are you able to see my screen? Am I audible?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes, Maheshwari.
Okay, ma'am. Thank you. So coming to magnesium silicata, the central theme of the magnesium silicata is the need to maintain a particular standard so that there is completion of electrons in the outer orbit. There is the stability we can see in silicata. So there is the standard particular image. I need to maintain a particular standard to get care, nourishment and protection. So this is the survival mechanism of magnesium silicata. So I'm going to share a case of Bell's palsy of magnesium silicate, 36 years female complaining of right-sided facial palsy with numbness of palms. The mouth is drawn to right side, pain in neck muscles, tinnitus of both the ears, palpitation. If anyone calls her, it will be followed by drawing of mouth. That much fear she has developed. If anyone calls her, then she just gets the fright and the mouth will be drawn to the right side. There is numbness of legs that will lead to difficulty in walking. There is family history of this mouth deviation to her mother also. And she also suffered 6 years ago. Control her anger. She this issue.
Maheshwari ma'am. Maheshwari ma'am. Ma'am, you are the host. Please mute these people.
Yes.
They are
yes,
not understanding.
Okay. So, how this problem of this facial palsy is affecting her? On inquiring, I am very much embarrassed with this issue if I can't go to the public. How everyone will look towards me. This bothers me a lot. So just on thinking itself, I used to sweat a lot in that moment. So I asked, there is issue with the husband. He used to drink and scold her. There is also severe fright. What is the main stress? And further asking, what's the main stress? What bothers you the most? She told that the husband's habit of drinking. So what if he drinks? What's the matter? What she told is she won't take care of my family. If he couldn't take the care, how the family will survive? How the child will grow up? So all the tension is about the children's future. They may become useless. So what? How that will be? How that feel like? Then she told that the kids will be like the ones without having the parents. So how the orphan will be? That is her delusion. If the husband won't take care of the family, that will affect the children's future. And how that is, they are grown up like the ones without having the parents. That is like an orphan. So what's the experience in that moment? Then she replied, that is loneliness, deserted, forsaken. What's the physical experience? She develops palpitation, shivering. There will be profuse sweating all over the body. So on further inquiring for the dreams, she told that the dreams of routine, that is as if her mouth is drawn to one side. What she experiences in daytime, that is that kind of same dreams she used to get. So what's the experience? That is very embarrassing. I can't speak with others. That will result in sweating of both the palms and sweats. So basing on this, this is also Sweetan sir's case. He prescribed magnesium silicate of 200. He repeated twice or thrice. So there is complete recovery. There is complete recovery. There is no more drawing of the mouth. The numbness is gone. The neck pain is gone. There is total recovery of the problem. So in this case, why I presented this is the clear picture of silicea. With that abandoned, children's issue, there is lost orphan. They may become orphan. That is in the experience part. And there is also the fear of embarrassment. She wanted to maintain some, she want to appear in the public in a specific way. But she couldn't. That's why she became embarrassed. Same kind of dreams she used to get, and that results in the sweating of palms and soles, what we know, that familiar symptom of silicea. So with this magnesium silicate, she recovered very well. Coming to magnesium fast, this is the salt of magnesium and phosphorus. The theme of phosphorus is love and care. How this is, when this phosphorus, it combines with magnesium, the theme will be the person from whom I see care and nourishment for survival, it is that person is indifferent to me, unloving to me, uncaring to me, and they are unaffectionate towards me. So this is the theme of magnesium fast. There is dependency for someone, but that dependency is not loving me, not caring me, that is very indifferent towards me. So that is expressed in delusions. Tetanus must die off with pain in right leg. As previously I told, magnesium fast, it is well known for neuralgias. So in tetanus, the delusion of he may die. The pain is to the extent that they may die. Next, the mind forgetfulness, heat after. See again how this magnesium is related to this heat. Heat after, there is forgetfulness. Mind lamenting, demoaning, wailing, pain from all the time. And suffering for hiccups. So with small suffering of hiccup, he is demoaning, lamenting, wailing. For what? As he wants the love, care, and the loving thing, that is not he is getting from the person on whom he depends, that is expressed as in an increased manner. For this small thing of hiccup, he starts lamenting, demoaning, wailing. So this is the expression. He starts shrieking, screaming, shouting with the cramps in the abdomen. That is the severity, intensity of the pain. Talking, suffering, troubles constantly of his. So to get that love and care, they start talk about repeatedly, saying repeatedly regarding those his complaints. So this is how to understand magnesium fast. So this is what I understood previously. Before going to Swara, I used to mug up the signs and symptoms from the different authors of Matra Medica. After going to Swara, entire my perception has changed. This is like previously I used to take the mango in my hand. Oh, how sweet it is. Just by mere looking at the mango, I thought that I am tasting, but it's not. I realized that after going to Swara, now I am tasting the sweetness of the real mangoes. The way of teaching is excellent. The sir teaches from the basics, how to look into the substance from the source, why this symptom came, how it is that much important. Just on reading Matra Medica books, it is like bits and parts. After going to Swara, we can get the thread, how to connect all these symptoms. The symptoms, they come together like as a bouquet. So this is what I experienced in Swara Gurukul workshop. So this is not with the understanding of medicinal substances. Beyond that, there is the art of interrogation. That is, and sir teaches very, very excellently. This is what Dr. Hahnemann told, na, the heart of homeopathy is the art of interrogation. So how to take the case, how to understand the person in front of us, that is crystal clearly explained, taught in Swara Gurukul workshop. This is my experience. So my dear friends, now I'm going to Swara since these 3 years. Now I'm early 40s. So at this age, now I am learning, but you are the wordings. You have very bright future further. Don't waste your energy. Don't waste your time. It's very, very important to visit this Swara Gurukul workshop and to learn at the feet of master. So I am very much indebted to sir. After going to Swara, there is a lot of difference in my practice, my way of perception. The previous cases which I am unable to do, where the cure was not happened, where there is a failure, now I am able to cure the cases. Now I am unable to take the case in a very different manner. The perception is entirely changed and the results are amazing. So I'm very, very much indebted to Dr. Shekhar sir. So any doubts?
Thank you, ma'am. Thanks for the wonderful session. And you have put forth everything about magnesium and its salt, everything in one place and in one session in such an elaborate manner in your crystal clear voice. Thank you so much, ma'am. Thank you. We would like to hear more from you. Participants, please raise your queries. Even you can type in the chat box as well.
I'm again requesting my dear friends, don't waste your valuable time. Don't think that we are the homeopaths as low graded. No, we are doing very wonderful job. We are treating the persons holistically. With this homeopathy, we can do amazing. When we meet the patients now, they just tell, ma'am, the surroundings are same. The issues with my mother-in-law, with my husband, they are same. But now I change. That is the thing our homeopathy medicines can do. So don't feel degraded. Don't think we just homeopaths. No, we can do so many things. Okay. To know individual remedies in depth, Kent Metra Medica, that is the basic book. Every Metra Medica has its own priorities. In Boric, we get something totality. So being the student, it's our duty to learn all the Metra Medica. So as well as the new Metra Medica books, that is from Rajan Shankaran sir, the sensation method, the structure, the book structure, and it deals with mineral remedies. So it's better to have understanding. You can collect the matter from where from it came. It's better to have the sessions under the master. So there one we should not to guide us how to look into the Metra Medica, how to study the Metra Medica. So just it's better to have the sessions or to attend the Gurukul workshop so that how to learn, how to look into the Metra Medica. The books will be there, the content will be there, but where to focus, that we don't know. So if we attend these workshops, our insights will increase. Yeah, MM books. All the books are very helpful. but how to see, where to see, what to see, this should be taught at the feet of master. After getting trained, you can also do wonders. Hope I meant the things, and I presented the things in everyone got understood. I reached you, I think so. And I'm thankful to the organizers of the college, Shivraj Homeopathic Medical College and Research Center, the principal, the chairman, the coordinator, ma'am Kirtika ma'am. And I am also thanks to Priyanka ma'am, Divya ma'am. Okay, I will share.
Yeah, it was a great learning and we would like to learn more from you. Thank you, ma'am. Thanks for your time and patience, teaching everything. Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am. Thanks a lot. Bye, friends.
Yes. Thanks to all the participants. And the video recordings are available. YouTube videos are available. You please ask for recordings. Thank you.